Solving equations by factoring. Solve by factoring. So, in the last video, we were seeing that if we have an expression that's equal to zero, we could use our product rule. But that means that we need to have some factors to be able to use our product rule. So if our expression is equal to zero, and we have an x squared and an x in our equation, we're going to need to factor before we can solve. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at a couple of examples. Here we've got x squared minus 4x minus 12 equals 0. So here I'm going to have to do some guessing and checking in order to factor the left-hand side. So I know that I need to have x and x to give me this x squared. Thinking maybe I want to do 3 and 4 for 12. If I did 3 and 4, that wouldn't add up to a 4 in the middle. Let's try 6 and 2. So then we would have minus 6 plus 2. Okay, so let's go ahead and double check that. Our outside terms would give us 2x. Inside terms would give us minus 6x. And those two added together would give us our negative 4x. So it looks like that's all good. So let's go ahead and continue from here. Now that we have the expression factored, we'll use our same rule as before. Set each factor equal to 0. X minus 6 equals 0. X plus 2 equals 0. Just took each of my factors and set them equal to 0. So then we have to solve for x, and here I get x equals 6, and here I get x equals negative 2. Again, either one of these will work to solve our equation, so we're going to have an or. Okay, so now looking at example 2, this one is a little bit trickier because I've got a coefficient in front of my x squared. It could be a little bit harder to factor. Got 3x squared plus x minus 4 equals 0. So I know right here that I want to have my 3x and my x. And I'm going to need to have 4 and a 1. Let's try putting the 1 right here and the 4 right here. And see, one of these is going to have to be positive, one's going to have to be negative. So see when we multiply these together what we get. So this would give us negative 12x, and the inside would give us 1x. Those together give us negative 11x. So that's definitely not what we want. Okay, so let's try again. So let's try right here, how about plus 4 and minus 1. Okay, yeah, so now we would have minus 3x and plus 4x. That will give us our plus x in the middle there. Okay, so now this is working. And then again, we just need to take each of our factors and set them equal to 0. So 3x plus 4 equals 0, and x minus 1 equals 0. So, minus 4, minus 4, 3x equals negative 4, divide by 3, divide by 3, x equals negative 4 thirds, plus 1, plus 1, x equals 1. So there's my two possible solutions, and I'm going to say or. Either one of those works.